Congressional Democrats could vote to impeach the president before the end of the year. The public hearings are wrapped for now, and lawmakers will head home for Thanksgiving. But that doesn't mean the investigation takes a break. Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi explains. Jason?
Wyatt, congressional staffers need to put together the evidence from these hearings, and then the Intelligence Committee will hand off their report to the House Judiciary Committee. They're the ones that have to decide whether to write articles of impeachment. But there's still a big outstanding question if they should wait for more witnesses, including White House Chief of Staff, Acting White House Chief of Staff Mick Mulvaney, but he's not responding. So if they want, this could lead to delays in a long legal fight.
Good morning. Good morning.
The Speaker of the House refuses to offer an impeachment timetable.
Can you clarify what you mean about the timing and...
No, I can't because there's no time. I don't know anything.
Democrats are fighting in court to hear from extra witnesses. However, that's not stopping their party from moving quickly.
So we cannot be at the mercy of the courts. The courts are very important in all of this. Those cases will continue. But I have never said we cannot proceed without the courts, because that's a technique on the part of the administration. Just keep ratcheting up to a higher court.
Democrats say the hearings already revealed what's needed for their investigation.
The evidence is clear that the president has used his office for his own personal gain, and in doing so undermined the national security of the United States by withholding military assistance to the Ukraine.
Republicans are standing by the president and point to one hole in the testimony. No one could personally say if the president directly linked withholding aid to Ukraine with his request for that country to investigate his political rivals.
Well, I think if you look at Sondland and the length of the interview, I would sum it up with one individual asking him questions. Congressman Mike Turner. He asked him, is anybody on the planet tell you in the process there had to be a quid pro quo or anything with holding up the aid? He said no.
And moderate Republican Will Hurd says the president's actions were inappropriate but not impeachable. And this division between Republicans and Democrats were seen on the national level. A recent Emerson College poll found 45% of the country does not support impeaching the president, 43% does. Wyatt?
Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi reporting. Thanks, Jason.